welcome Mr. Ramakrishnan with a huge round of applause as he's joining us on the dais. Welcome back, sir. And ladies and gentlemen, please bring on stage our guest of honor, Dr. BBL Madhukar. Thank you very much, sir, for joining us at the Excellence Awards and Recognition Ceremony. So the awards, ladies and gentlemen, will be presented in several categories. And at this point, I'm having to extend a very, very warm welcome to Dr. Madhukar once again. Welcome, sir. Now I'm going to request Mr. Ramakrishnan to actually take us through the process, the jury process, and also set a context for these awards of the year 2016 at this point, sir.
Very good evening to each one of you. I think it's been very engaging conversation right since the morning, and we have come to the pinnacle of our event today. I shared briefly in the morning for the benefit of all, someone would have come in after the morning session. We had the privilege and pride to honor and felicitate Shri B.V.R. Mohan Reddy as the Pioneering Business Leader Award in the morning. So I think I would once again at this moment give a round of applause to him in his absence here. At that time, I read out some of the specifics of the process for the Pioneering Business Leader. And I thought it's appropriate to share very quickly about what's the process which Shared Services Forum adopts for this evening just now. Shared Services Forum, as Sanjay started in the morning, you know, was initiated in 2011. And from 2011, we have been having excellence awards for the companies. And some of the companies which have received awards are Hindustan Unilever, Airtel, and we have had opportunities to look at ICICI Bank and multiple future group, Dr. Reddy's, and so on and so forth. So we have had great moments of pride in those years as we started. 2014 was the first year when Shared Services Forum moved on to recognize pioneering leaders. The first set of pioneering leaders we had was two stalwarts of the industry, and we looked at both from the business process side as well as from the client perspective, because one of the things we believe in the Shared Services Forum is to make sure that we bring this power of client and the service partner together. As you see today, we have spent a lot of time from the direct practitioners and clients talking to us about what they have done and how well they have done. So Mr. Raman Roy was the first pioneering entrepreneurial leader who was felicitated in 2014, and Mr. Akhil Gupta, the vice chairman of Airtel, was the person who was felicitated as the pioneering business leader, as the person who made the first largest outsourcing to happen from the client perspective to IBM, you know, way back. I think it shook the industry. It was one of the disruptions which happened in the industry at that point in time. Last year, we had two more leaders who were recognized in 2015. One was Mr. Rakesh Gupta, the managing director of Allianz Insurance Company. The center was started in Trivandrum. In fact, the entire Trivandrum was vitalized by that unit to really create an explosion of shared services and business process management in the entire state of Kerala. So Mr. Rakesh Gupta actually was recognized as the pioneering business leader for not just for setting up a shared service center, but making a difference to a state of Kerala, and also implementing the Carnegie Mellon model, which is e-sourcing capability model. Mr. K. Ramesh was recognized as the pioneering BPM achiever last year. Ramesh set up the first shared services for Hindustan Unilever as a manufacturing unit. As you know, all of us have been exposed to service industry, you know, whether we come from American Express or ANZ or Allianz, I can take any number of names. Very few manufacturing companies can actually claim to have set up the shared services, and Hindustan Unilever was the first one from the manufacturing company to set up the center. So K. Ramesh was awarded the pioneering BPM Achiever Award last year. All this goes through the process. I shared about the jury panel. We have a very, very elite jury panel, Mr. V.V. Ranganathan, senior partner, former senior partner of Ernst & Young, who also has driven the World Entrepreneurship Awards in India. You know, I've been part of many of such celebrations. Mr. Ram Sundar, who was the president of Pepsi, he was CFO for Ranbaxy, and today is managing private equity. He understands the business services space very well. And Mr. T. Chandrasekhar, the CFO for IBM. So we have a very select leadership which actually looks through this process. I'll very briefly therefore share with you the BPM Achiever, and what this year we have initiated is to translate the pioneering BPM Achiever to the next level, to identify and felicitate BPM Achievers who are leaders who have made a difference, who have actually been able to create transformational strategic impact to the organizations. And I can surely say, having been part of this industry for 20 years, that there are, you know, India has got several such leaders. And of course, therefore, it took us time to identify a few to start with who will actually make a difference. So we will today announce three leaders, one leader who is the pioneering BPM achiever, and two leaders who are BPM achievers in their own way of contribution, and we'll share that. Quickly, from an achiever point of view, morning I shared about leaders, the achiever parameters are slightly different. The achiever's parameters again are six. First, BPM operations leadership. Individual contribution to the company on strategic execution. Sustained focus to enhance BPM strategy. Transformation orientation. Team management and governance. Organizational business impact. These are the six parameters on which BPM achievers have been identified, and that process has been continued. And from a company point of view, the parameters for judgment is really based on effective BPM strategy, establishing customer-oriented practices, change culture and communication, people and talent management, knowledge management, automation, and value orientation and maturity. So this is the parameters on which we have looked at the various companies in this year as we received. So this is just to briefly tell you the process is quite intense. We have put a very, very robust structure. It goes through rigorous and, you know, interestingly, all the three leaders can not just look at the big picture of the jury panel, but also the detail. They ask questions which are very, very specific and simple. So, you know, the team behind Shared Services Forum has put together this. So I just wanted to kind of convey that it's a very, very robust process. If some people do not get an award, it is nothing to say that those people have not done well. It is just that the whole process is very, very robust, and it's got certain amount of parameters driven, and that's about all. So with those few words, I will request Rakesh Sinha to take it forward.
So thanks, Ravi. I think we'll move with the first category, Ashwarya.
And the first category, ladies and gentlemen, in the Pioneer Awards category is Pioneering BPM Achiever in Global India. So the category is Pioneer Awards, and the award is for the Pioneering BPM Achiever in Global India, as stated by Mr. Ramakrishnan.
So I'll request Ravi to read the citation and announce the name, Ravi.
Currently the president of HCL Financial Services Division, and Rakesh will read out the citation in terms of what he has done differently to become the pioneering BPM Achiever Award. And his citation on the trophy is for creativity and leading global enterprise-wide shared services and BPM mission, delivering value and business transformational impact.
Unfortunately, Rahul is not here in person today. He is traveling. He is in US as we speak now. And what I'll do is I'll read out quickly his profile, ladies and gentlemen. And we have a small video clip sent by Rahul today morning. So we'll play as that. Rahul Singh, as Ravi said, he's the president, Financial Services Division, SCL Technologies. He's the president of $1.7 billion vertical, with over 30 years of rich experience in global in-house captive operations, IT infrastructure, and BPO services to Citibank and HCL's Fortune 500 Global 2000 global clients across banking, financial services, and insurance. After 25 years with Citibank, he joined SCL in 2010 and is responsible for leading financial services business, developing client relationships, and investing in strategic initiatives to meet the next generation technology and operations needs of client. Rahul founded the Citibank Citigroup Global Services, aka eServe International. I'm sure many of us know about eServe International, in 1999, and is credited as the pioneer in offshoring operations for the banking industry in India. He was the chief executive officer of Citigroup Global Services Limited since 1999, and also its managing director since 2001. eServe grew to a 12,500 people organization with multiple service lines and was acquired by TCS in 2009. The company was the global in-house center subsidiary of Citibank in India, specializing in financial processing and customer service center operations, servicing city centers over 50 countries in Asia, Middle East, Africa, Europe, and US for a complete range of banking products, cash management, trade, loans, corporate personal mortgages, cards, branch banking, etc., etc. As CEO of CGSL, Rahul was responsible for formulation of its vision and growth strategy over a 10-year period. This included building the management team, identifying key markets, selecting domain to focus on building the necessary infrastructure, premises, telecommunication, HR plan and strategy, migration methodologies, etc. CGSL was the first publicly listed company listed as eServe on Mumbai Stock Exchange until December 2004, when Citi acquired 97% stake via an open offer. At the time of delisting in 2004, the company had 20,000 shareholders, including 15% stake held by institutional investors. The company's stock price had moved early 100 times from rupees 10, 20 cents a share in 1999 to rupees 975 USD 2020 per share in December 2004. In late 2008, Citi divested eServe to TCS for an valuation of $525 million. Rahul played an active role during the sale of the company and in fact continued his role in TCS to enable smooth transition. At the time of sale, the company had revenues of $275 million, was Citi's largest global in-house captive center, processing over 700 million transactions and responding to over 75 million customer contacts every year. Rahul has been nominated among 10 emerging companies of the year by Economic Times twice in 2002 and 2003, the eServe. eServe in the last 10 years has been recognized, and thanks to the pioneering role played by Rahul, the first prize at the hands of the President of India for fastest growth in the STPI SME segment for 2001-2002, most innovative IT-ITS company in government of Maharashtra, first listed in BPO, listed BPO in India and delisting in 2004, top 13 best managed companies in India listed by A.T. Kearney Business Today in 2005, the most customer responsive BPO in India by Economic Times, top three captive BPOs in India, Times of India 2004. These are a few of the achievements of the company which was pioneered by Rahul Singh. And ladies and gentlemen, let's put our hands together to give a round of applause to Rahul Singh. A video clip, please.
Gentlemen, first of all, I would like to thank the Shared Service Forum for felicitating me as a pioneer BPM achiever in Global India. I would like to also thank the jury members, the jury chair, Mr. V. Ranganathan, jury members, Mr. Ramasundaran, T. Chandrasekharan, and Ravi Ramakrishnan, founder of Shared Service Forum, for this recognition. My journey in this industry began in 1998 when I became the CEO of eServe. eServe was India's first financial services BPO. In the early years, we had many skeptics. We had to explain to the municipalities, to the government, to our shareholders, and to our employees what we were trying to do and what we were trying to achieve as a group. Through the years, and it has now been nearly two decades since we started this industry, we were proved right in terms of quality, in terms of productivity, in terms of our people. The Indian industry is second to none, and it is reflected by the fact that it is the largest outsourcing industry in BPO globally. Of course, as we look at the future, we have new challenges. Our customers expect us to have a digital, a more productive, a more automated, a higher amounts of robotics, a higher amount of customer experience driven focus. I'm sure with the quality of people and the innovation that we have in the industry, we will be able to prove once again that we are the best and have a great global future ahead. And therefore, it is so apt today that we are discussing what are the ways in which we need to reboot the business process strategies for the future. As I wind up, I would like to thank my team at eServe, which stood with me for nearly 12 years, and later on, my team at HCL, which has been with me for the last 5 years. I would also like to thank my wife and my children for having been with me, behind me, all the way through my journey in this industry. Thank you very much, and all the best.
And with that, the next category is BPM Achiever Awards, and we have two awardees in the same category. So for the first awardee, BPM Achiever in Global India.
Yeah. So I'll request Mr. Ramakrishnan to read the citations, please.
Going through the details, and so we have got two leaders who are identified, and one of the two leaders whose name I have great pride to announce is Mr. Pradeep Kapoor. In recognition of stellar contribution in a transformational strategic leadership and operations role in Global India, delivering value and business transformational impact.
So I'll read the profile of Pradeep for, because it's not part of the delegate kit, and then I'll request Dr. Madhukar to hand over the trophy to Pradeep. Before inviting Mr. Kapoor, I'll read his profile briefly. Mr. Kapoor is a Senior Vice President and General Manager for American Express Global Customer Fulfillment Network, Japan, Asia Pacific, and Global Process Excellence. He's responsible for the Global Servicing Network at American Express for Japan, Asia Pacific region, managing a headcount of 9,000 across 8 countries and 12 sites. In addition, he is the global head of the customer fulfillment network across 23 markets. He also leads global process excellence for the servicing network at American Express. In his role, he oversees the operations of a world-class organization delivering superior service to American Express card members in both US and international markets.
In addition to being a member of the Global Servicing Network leadership team, he's also a member of the India leadership team and leads several initiatives across American Express. He's the managing regulatory interfaces and representing American Express at appropriate industry association. Pradeep is a chartered accountant from the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India and has an honors degree in economics from Hindu College, Delhi University. He has over 30 years of experience, and prior to joining American Express, he was the chief financial officer of GE Capital. He has received several global awards in his illustrious career. His noteworthy contributions to the company include, and not limited to, developed and implemented a people strategy that revolutionized the business model and approach of American Express to servicing from India and transformed the business model for shared services. Devised a strategy to transform the American Express global servicing footprint with 50% of US customers being serviced from India. Transformed customer servicing to technology-led and person-assisted versus the other way around by leveraging automation and robotics. Embedded relationship care as a servicing strategy to add value in each customer interactions, thereby creating an emotional connect with the customer. Led American Express in its first participation in the Great Places to Work survey in 2005, which paved the way for American Express to leverage learnings from the survey and thereafter secure a place in the top 10 for 10 years in a row. One of the three companies to have achieved this in India. And its inclusion into the GPW Hall of Fame in 2015. He made significant contribution to the industry as well, pioneered the champion challenger model between proprietary and partner operations to enhance organizations' flexibility, optimize cost, and improve quality and BCP preparedness. Provided insights of customer experience in India for all industry segments, leveraging the customer barometer study. This was published in Times of India, Financial Express, and the Hindu Business Line. Provided counsel to several global organizations looking to set up Indian organizations, operations on the right business model and the approach to balance cost and value, and tap premium talent to create a world-class operating center. Mentored high-potential women leaders from different companies with a reach-out program to enable them to realize their professional aspirations. With this, I request Mr. Pradeep Kapoor to join us on dais, Dr. Madhukar to please share the trophy with. Request Mr. Kapoor to do a quick acceptance speech, please.
Thank you to the Shared Services Forum and the jury for giving me this honor. I'll just say this, that the profile that was read out was much more appreciative of me than I think myself, but I'll say a few words. First and foremost, I have been associated with this industry for a while, both at General Electric, where I looked at it from a finance perspective, and these were the years the industry had just about started. And then later on at American Express, and I do certainly believe that American Express was one of the companies that laid the seed for this industry to flourish and evolve. I think the most important ingredient of at least the BPM industry is its people. That's how the journey began in India. And I say this to everybody and anybody who cares to listen, that it's the quality of talent that you select, not hire, that drives everything else. I was so pleased when so many questions were being raised about people strategy. Vivek talked about people and engagement in his organization. That truly is the foundation. I think sometimes in this industry we confuse it is the other ingredients that make the difference. Believe me, India has a terrific advantage along with some other Asian countries that I happen to lead, where we can get the best of the best in India to really outperform everybody else. And I say this, that such talent in other countries companies would go bankrupt in selecting them. So one piece of advice I have is, don't try to squeeze every drop of the lemon as you bring work to India to return a very high fraction to either your profits if you are a third party or back to the parent if you are a GIC. Reserve some for the people. Because with a little bit of extra investment, both at the time of selection and then in keeping them with you, you drive a huge advantage. I say this with full humility and having lived through this experience, both from a cost perspective initially and then transforming it in 2008 for American Express, that if you hire people who are world beaters here, they will give you a substantial edge. And I'm proud to say today that a call of an American Express US customer when it lands in India or in the Philippines drives higher customer satisfaction as measured by the customer than when the same call lands in the US. That's the great tribute to the talent that we have here in this country. So if there's one thing I'll say again and again, select the best people. And that does not mean that you offer them the highest salaries. It's the entire ecosystem which goes along with being the best employer. So one thing that was read out as my contribution was the place of American Express in the top 10 for 10 years in a row in the great places to work. Those of you who are familiar with that award, 2/3 of the weightage is given by anonymous people survey, which the GPTW organization sends directly to your employees. You have to give them a list of employees, they select on random, they will send it from their mailbox, the response goes direct. If your people are not truly happy, then forget about the top 10, you cannot be even in the top 100. So investing in people in this industry, I believe, whether from a skill development perspective, providing them the best environment, et cetera, is the first thing that any leader in this industry should invest time in. The second, I think, point that was made, at least in the last panel conversation, was the advantage of technology. With the changing demographics from a customer perspective, with the changing demographics in our employee population, it is increasingly important that your capabilities and technology keep pace with those demographics. And those companies who lead in that, whether doing it themselves or getting others to do it for them, will succeed. Because I think it is the entire interaction of the customer, both with the technology and capabilities of the company, as well as with the human people in the company, the employees of the company, that makes up the total customer experience. American Express invested a lot of time and effort in really making that human interaction world class. And globally, and especially in the US, we have been winners of JD Power, which is, and being number one in that spot for many years in a row. I think the other component is now becoming even more so important. And as he read out, I think we are at an inflection point where we will probably become more technology-led and people or person-assisted rather than the other way around. I know the balance conversation we did have, what's the right balance, but I think the way the world is evolving, customer needs are evolving, there is an inflection point and we'll tip more to the technology side. The third point that I did want to make is that everybody tries to fulfill customer requirements. It is those companies who will not just fulfill stated customer requirements, but the unstated customer requirements and even beyond that will go forward in a big way, and those who do not will stay behind. And one thought that we do have as we provide service to our card members is how do you add value in that moment of interaction? A person may call you just for making a payment, a customer may call you just for finding out their balance. But the value that you provide beyond that creates that lasting impression. So if you are seeing, for instance, that a card member has a number of membership reward points, which are points that they earn for spending, and they're making a number of trips to a particular city, though they call just for that balance, making the point that you can probably use the points to redeem and actually pay for the tickets that you're making. Not a thing that the customer had called for in the first instance, but that makes the impact, just to give you an illustration. So thank you very much for the award. I know I'm speaking to already people who are masters of this industry, but I thought I'll just make a few comments. Thank you very much. I'm really privileged.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
And now to the other recipient in the same category, BPM Achiever in Global India.
So I'll request Ravi to read the citation, please.
This person is, as Pradeep said, is also a person who is absolutely an outstanding leader. And the person's name is Ms. Pankajam Sridevi. In recognition of stellar contribution in a transformational strategic leadership and operations role in Global India, delivering value and business transformational impact. Leader.
So congratulations, Ms. Pankajam Sridevi. I'll just read a quick profile and then I'll invite you on the stage. Ms. Pankajam Sridevi is the managing director of ANZ Bangalore Hub. She is heading a team of almost 7,000 staff in technology and operations based in Bangalore, the information technology hub of India. Prior to ANZ, Pankajam had worked in reputed companies and has over 28 years of rich experience in diverse segments ranging from manufacturing, technology, including design of integrated process automation systems, technology service management and software development and IT-enabled services. Pankajam is leading the technology and operations team in supporting key global initiatives of the bank by building their core capabilities. She works with the leadership team to embrace end-to-end process improvements through a culture of change to get improved customer service, capability build, compliance and cost reduction. Pankajam has been driving the automation initiative in the delivery centers of ANZ. She plays a key role in the adoption of robotics, process automation, RP across multiple functional groups and countries. Pankajam has been at the forefront of leading the diversity and inclusion agenda in ANZ through her steadfast focus on increasing the hiring of women leaders and persons with disabilities. I mean, it's a very important point, hiring of women leaders and persons with disabilities. Pankajam was announced as the winner of NCP-EDP Mindtree Helen Keller Award 2016 as a role model supporter of increased employment opportunities for disabled people. Earlier in the year, she also received Exemplary Women Leadership Achievement Award by World Women Leadership Congress, an award WWLCA 2016. Under Pankajam's leadership and vision, ANZ Bangalore Hub received the prestigious NASSCOM DNI Award for PWD Inclusions, NCPEDP Lemon Tree Hotels Helen Keller Award 2015, and Nip Man Foundation Award 2016 for being a role model organization for persons with disability. Pankajam's ability to strategize, ideate, and have really ambitious plans executed through a large group of leaders in our organization in her key strength. Her ability to inspire and build a groundswell with a very transparent and authentic leadership style is a key contributor for the success of the robotic program in ANZ. She inspires everybody from the grassroots levels to her direct reports to successfully execute ideas into reality, which makes her an outstanding leader. Pankajam holds an engineering degree from NIT Kozhikode. Prior to ANZ, she has spent most of her career with Wipro and ABB across technology, operations, and engineering. With this, I request Ms. Pankajam Sridevi to come on the dais, please, and Dr. Madhukar to hand over the award.
Great pleasure.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
I request Ms. Pankajam Sridevi to do a quick award acceptance speech, please.
Great achievement, really.
Good evening, everyone.
All of them, very good.
While the citation was being read, I just wish my boss was here. It would have been the best performance review that I've ever had. So I'm very proud that I got nominated and I've been selected for the BPM Achiever Award. So I want to thank Shared Services Forum and Mr. Revi for that. I'm also proud that I'm sharing it with Mr. Pradeep. The citation was longer. I'm very proud of it. But one thing that attracted my attention, sir, was that you're really a people-oriented leader, and also you're supporting women to grow. What more do you need to be inspired to be sharing the award with you? So I think you have had a very busy day, but I was there for the two sessions, and I'm sure it was very, very informative, and there'll be a lot of things for us to go back and do. You can see how important customer service is. It's nice that all of us think that we really manage stated and unstated requirements of customer. I think it's also because there is very stiff competition, and the people or the organizations that really do not look at unstated wishes of customers are no more there. So a clear example is I feel really sad for HMT, but if you compare HMT and Titan, the only reason why Titan has become like ladies' watches and it's become like a sign of luxury and fashion is because Titan really went ahead and thought about the unstated requirements that women have to change watches in line with their dress. So I think that's a clear example, and there are hundreds of such examples. And I must say that, you know, if I go back to ANZ, we have had a great year. We went into automation, and I'm very glad that we are kind of seen as trendsetter in the industry. But it's all because of people. It cannot be just me. It's because of a leadership that doesn't fear change and doesn't fear the very big concept that all analysts and others bring, saying that will we lose jobs. So I really want to dedicate this award to the entire team of ANZ who stood by me like rock and said that let's change to make things easy for customer. Because the big thing is, of course, taking care of unstated requirements, but also making it very easy for customers to bank with us. So it's my team who really made me the BPM Achiever of the Year. They have believed in me, and they made sure that we move with quickness and get it into ANZ in nine places across the world. So thank you once again, and it is really great to be here. And I'm sure that Shared Services Forum will continue the great work that you're doing by getting all experts into the forum, maybe more women, sir, next time. But, and also ensuring that this information is transferred to everyone to bring India to the global positioning of not just cost arbitrage, but of value-driven culture and value arbitrage. Thank you.
With that, ladies and gentlemen, we now move on to the category of company awards. And the first award in this category is for shared services in Indian subcontinent.
So I'll request Mr. Sanjay Gupta to read the citations, please.
Okay. A few words.
Yes, please, go ahead.
Just about this reference which is made, Sri Devi. Just, sorry, excuse me for this, because he referred to HMT. And Tanisk. Because HMT, I happen to be a board level director in HMT.
Sorry, sir, I didn't know that.
many years ago, several decades ago, when it was flourishing. And there used to be requests from members of parliament that, you know, here's somebody from my constituency, he wants to marry his daughter. But the boy's side, boy is wanting a HMT watch. And the marriage is delayed because there is a waiting period of 6 months to get a watch. So marriage is delayed because of this reason. Can you make it available now so that we can fix the date for marriage? So that was one time. But as you know, this was public sector. And public sector is identified with an elephant. compared to a private sector company like Tanisk, which could be compared to a horse, and horse would be faster. So therefore, the lesson which we all can derive sitting here to solve many management issues, that the speed decides your growth. That is the lesson. Horse represented speed, and elephant was opposed to it. So therefore, elephant lost, because you couldn't stand competition. And competition is the biggest guru, which no management person can ever ignore. Competition, that's the key word. Face the competition. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for particularly that piece of that marriage was very powerful, and I think it was a good connect of he being a board of director for HMT and, you know, we are thinking about HMT, so it was nice. So I request Mr. Sanjay Gupta to read the citation, please. Sanjay, come here.
Here, Sanjay. So the citation.
So this is the
you say. So this is the Shared Services, 6th Annual Shared Services Excellence Award in the Indian subcontinent. And the organization that has been identified for this is Mahindra Integrated Business Solutions Private Limited.
I request Dr. Madhukar to hand over the award. So I'll request Mahesh if you want to do a quick acceptance note.
Thanks for telling me that. Thank you very much, Shared Services Forum. As Ravi said, I'll not take more than 30 seconds. What makes me really happy is, it's 2.5 years since I've started this journey. And trust me, the name Mahindra is a very big name. But we started this venture with just two people. One is me, and second is an internal resource from Mahindra Integrated Business Solutions, who unfortunately told the CEO of our company that he wants to do something different after 10 years of being there. So they told him, move from Nagpur to Bombay. This is one guy, help him the way he wants. We didn't have a place to sit because our new building was still coming up. We have actually sat on staircases and worked when we started this venture. And while I take pride in correlating to many of the large entrepreneurs who have started their ventures from garages, I can at least say that I've started my venture from sitting in staircase. And this is the first award that we are getting for this venture in the name that we have created from an external body. So it's indeed a very proud moment for me. And I thank you on behalf of the entire MIBS team. Thank you very much. Thank you.
So congratulations, Mahindra's team. We'll move to the next one.
Check. Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, the next company award is for delivering business impact through people practices.
I'll request Sanjay to read the citation, please. That's a process.
Absolutely. So the 6th Annual Shared Services Excellence Awards for delivering business impact through people practices. And the organization selected for this is Tata Motors Limited.
Thank you.
Congratulations, Sandeep. You want to just have a quick 30 seconds acceptance?
Sorry for this.
No problem. So I think people, I think we spoke about how important people are. That is the most important asset. That's the most important ingredient of any shared services. So we got awards in process improvement, automation last year. This year we thought, okay, let's try and see whatever we do in the people practices. Are we doing well? Are we doing better? And how can we do better? So thank you for the award. Thank you, Shared Services Forum. It's always been a pleasure meeting all the people here and learning several things which I did today. Thank you.
Congratulations, sir. The next award, ladies and gentlemen, is for delivering business impact through process excellence, again in the same category of company awards.
I'll request Mr. Anand Maheshwari to come and read the citations, please.
So the 6th Annual Shared Services Excellence Awards, Delivering Business Impact Through Process Excellence, goes to ESSEL, SL Business Excellence Services Limited.
Thanks, Ravi and Shared Service Forum for inviting us today. This award is not for me. This award for each and every member of EBEX who has been working relentlessly day and night to create value for each of our customers. Our philosophy of customer first, business process improvement, business output, and digital transformation is key to where we are today. This is a journey which we would keep continuing it and better our service in the days to come. Thank you, everyone, and team. Three cheers. Thank you.
Moving on to the next award, which is for delivering business impact through technology transformation for India.
So Anand, please do the honors.
Pleasure. 6th Annual Shared Services Excellence Awards, Delivering Business Impact Through Technology Transformation. And this, India, and this goes to Dr. Reddy's Laboratory Limited.
Request you to do a quick acceptance speech. The ground rules remain the same.
So thank you, SSF, and the jury, and also the team behind the efforts. Some of us were here, but quite a few of them are not here. They are back in Hyderabad and various places of the country. So it's been a concerted effort. I think we are going in the right direction. So this is one such indication that it's been recognized for the good work going on there. And I believe that we have many more miles to go, and certainly we are on the right direction. Thank you once again.
Congratulations. And moving on to the next award, which is Delivering Business Impact Through Technology Transformation, GIC, and that goes to?
So I'll request Mr. Renu Rajesh to read the citations, please. Renu, if you can just do the honors, please.
For 6th Annual Shared Services Excellence Award, Delivering Business Impact Through Technology Transformation, and the award goes to
GIC.
Sorry. ANZ Bengaluru Hub.
Pankajam, 30 more seconds?
I think I already spoke.
Okay.
Congratulations, ma'am. And with that, ladies and gentlemen, it's now time for a recognition for effective shared services implementation in India.
You want to talk about that? Just go ahead, Ravi.
Sir, Ravi wants to make
just
a point.
30 seconds. You know, we this year onwards, I think it didn't specifically mention, we have initiated the awards for the GIC, Global In-House Centers, separately, because we realize that the benchmarks and the comparisons are very different, and we need to make sure that those are kept separately. And just to tell you that Dr. Reddy's, had implemented P2P automation in a wonderful way, and they had given the entire details behind it, backing it up in terms of what happened and what's the sponsorship. I think it was an amazing story from an India perspective, and from a GIC perspective, it was obviously amongst many, the one which was chosen was the robotics process automation at ANC Bengaluru Hub. So that's the difference. So I think as we start this year, we will have more such, meaning, so GIC and India will be seen separately to make sure the right comparisons are made when we look at what we need to do. Thank you so much. Back to you.
Thank you, Mr. Ramakrishnan. So for the recognition on effective shared services implementation in India.
I request Mr. Bhaskar from SEMA to join us on the dais, please.
This is for effective shared services implementations in India, and the citation. Kuoni Group.
Request your quick acknowledgement of the award. 30 seconds.
This is the first time I'm attending this kind of a conclave. So first time when I heard about it, I was quite interested because we have been running this shared service for last 7 years now. It was started with a small idea of setting it up just for India, just to see if we can do something together. And now the shared service that I run is supporting 45 countries across the globe, nearly 6,000 employees. And by next year, the remaining migration, once it gets over, it will be 65 countries and 10,000 employees. So that's the setup that we have. So I thought, okay, let's see, and it will be an interesting thing to hear. So it was a very good day today, and I could hear different perspectives. So we had our own perspective, and I could gain from here. And thank you very much that it was recognized. Thank you to the Shared Service Forum. Thank you.
Congratulations. Thank you.